Hello guys, how do you do? Welcome to the show at Programming Wizards. Now we are continuing with the framework 7, a series of tutorial. Today we're going to see, we are of course still working with our tabs, but then we're going to see how to render, of course, images and text right here in content blocks, okay, for each particular page. Now this is what I'm talking about. This is my home page. Of course, I can move to the drama. You can see right here we have different content, okay, and of course the image also. Then action right here you can also see, and then of course documentary also. You can see that you are having, of course, different pages with our images and text, and of course we are rendering them nicely with content blocks. This is what we're going to see. So this one right here, this is our content title, our content subtitle, these are content, and then of course these are image. Guys, this is it. This is what we're going to see, how to work, of course, with content blocks and of course images and text, and how to display them, of course, in toolbar tabs. Now, so the first thing that of course we're going to need, I'll need you guys to go ahead create our project. Please, if you're not sure, just go to our first episode. We saw how to create a project. Okay, now I'm assuming you guys have created the project. So once you've done so, copy some images and then bring them right here in our images folder. You can see, for instance, I'm having these are my images right here. These are the images that of course I'm going to be using. Okay, so just make sure that you add them in our images folder. We shall be referencing them from over there. That's it. That's what the only thing we need to do there, right there. Of course, if you had some custom CSS, you can write them in our my app.css. We don't need any for today. And then of course JavaScript, we're going to write a small JavaScript right here in our my app.js. Then of course create another folder, right click, create your folder. Then of course have read there this particular just actually, okay, we'll come to these ones. In fact, no, let's just go ahead and create them. So come right here, then HTML file. Now you can use any text editor that you like. For me right here, I'm using my WebSom right here. Okay, then of course we'll come to those particular pages. Let's start right here with our index.html. Now this is a HTML file. The first thing we need to make sure that we create, of course, this right here, our, we add all, of course, our DOM objects, HTML, head, title, then of course our body, okay. Then of course inside our body, as the last thing, inside the last thing that shall get executed, we're going to be importing our JavaScript that we did add right in our JS folder. We're also going to make sure that we import the framework 7 JavaScript. We're adding them as the last in the body because actually we shall want it, the JavaScript of course, to get loaded once we've, the whole page is already loaded, to make our page a little bit faster. So then we also need to import some frameworks, actually some CSS references. First, we're using the material design theme. So come right here, make sure that you import material. Also the colors also right here. Now, suppose you had some CSS, you'd also just make sure that you add them right there. Then of course we have the views, okay. Now of course our page, each single page can consist of several views. Now in this case, right here, we're going to have our main view. So we're giving it the class view main, okay. So what we're going to do inside right here, the first thing we're going to be defining, of course, our navigation bar, this one right here, okay. This is our nav bar, okay. So take note, we have of course the title, we also have this one right here, okay. This particular this one right here, okay. This particular image is going to represent for us the menu. So you can see this right here is our title, we have it at the center. Then of course at the right we have that particular menu, all right. We have icon, actually icon bars right here. So that's it, that's our navigation bar. The next thing, we're going to come to our toolbar. Now what's our toolbar? Well, of course our toolbar is this one right here. Take note, of course, as you can see, it consists of this particular actually tabs, okay, links that of course take us to our tabs. So just make sure that you have your toolbar right here. Then the next thing, of course, we're just going to make sure that, okay, for our home what's our home? Well, it's right here, index.html. okay, we're just calling it home. Then of course drama, we shall be referencing from our pages directory. Then of course as action as well, and of course the documentary as well. So once we have those ones, then we're also going to define our page content. Now take note, we're using the navbar fixed right here. So div class pages, then of course data page. Now this is the ID for that particular page. This particular page, it's our index page. Okay, then we're going to come right here, we have our page content. All right, now for instance our page content is going to be of course whatever is going to be right here. Okay, so our page content is all these ones. You can see title, subtitle, content, and then of course our image, whatever we're going to have right here. So let's come get started here. Of course first we're defining the content block title that we've just seen. Of course the title right here, Breaking Bad, and then of course the subtitle, action. Then we come our content block. Okay, so we're going to come right here, we add our content. Now this is the content. Of course you can add whatever content you like already. And then what about our image? Well, for our image we're simply referencing from our img folder. So you can see right here, then we give it the width that we like. Okay, that's it. This is going to do of course for our right here, is going to do for of course our index.html. okay, so it's this simple. This is the only thing we need. Next let's move on. Not really, before we move to our JavaScript we need to come to our pages. So let's start with the action.html. So the first thing of course we need to define our navigation bar right here. We simply give it the title right there, then we come to our pages. So of course this is our page ID right here, then our page content, we add our content for this particular action page. Now take note right here, the title inside our content block title, then of course the subtitle, then of course right here we have our content. Okay, so content, and then below it we have our image. Take note the image that we are referencing right here. That's it. That's the only thing we need to do right here. That's of course we also come to our documentary.html. We do the same thing. First we're going to specify our navigation bar with our title, then we come to our pages. Right now our page content, inside our page content right here we're going to define first our content block, then of course our content block title right here, and the subtitle also, and then we come have our content right here. So take note of course this one right here, this is our content, then of course the image also we are referencing it from our img directory. You can give it the height or width that of course you like. Of course we're also going to come to our drama right here. So the drama, the same thing just as we've been doing. First of course we need our navigation bar, all right, with its title, then below it we have our page. All right, so first we define our class pages, then of course the particular page right here we assign it an ID, it's called drama. So this one, this particular ID that we have been assigning right here, it can help us for instance if we want to identify this particular page. Let's say that we want to handle the page load event for each particular page. Now we shall can simply do that by referencing right here this particular base ID, okay, using our DOM selector. So in our page content, this is where we're going to have our content. So first we're having our title, our content title, okay, and of course our subtitle right here. Then we going to have our content. Now this is our content, then of course the image is just the same thing that actually we've been doing. So that's it guys, let's move over to our JavaScript. So for our JavaScript there's really nothing big deal right here. First of course we just have our function right here. Now we're going to initialize right here our framework 7. Okay, so let's come right here, framework 7, we're initializing it, and then of course assigning it to our my app. Then of course DOM 7 right here, we are sending it to this particular double dollar sign right here. okay, our selector. So this is what we can use to select our DOM objects. And then of course from work 7 my operator, we can use it of course to access the functions of course and objects from our framework 7. So in this case we're simply going to call our add view method. Then of course we are passing it the view main. The view main class is actually the class that we did specify right here. What we're doing over there, here it is, okay, we said that inside these particular views we can have several views, and then of course those particular views we have to register them of course to our framework 7. So that's what our my app right here, our framework 7 object, is doing for us. We shall be using a dynamic navigation bar. Then of course at the end of the day we simply come just call our function right here by calling application, okay. So that's it guys, that's what we need right here. Let's go ahead run our project. Of course if we run our project right here, this is what we're getting. Now as you can see we are able to switch through the particular tabs. They all have the images and of course our text. We said this one right here, our title, our subtitle. Then of course we have, as you can see right here, our content. Then of course our image, the same for each particular page. You okay, this does it. This was to introduce us of course to content blocks as well as images and of course the tabs right here. There you can use all of those together. So I'm hoping you guys have enjoyed this tutorial. If you have, leave us a like below. Make sure that you guys subscribe so that you don't miss any of our framework 7 tutorial. We normally do post to a lot of tutorials. Also we have Android tutorials native for native development using Java and also using C# Xamarin, okay. So make sure that you guys check those out. We also have our website camposha.info. You can find the source code for our tutorials right there. So also go there and check it out. Take care, I'll catch you in the next tutorial.